Hi and welcome back to this channel. This video is the continuation of the previous videos I made on if statements and if else statements. In these videos, we learned about how to implement one-way and two-way selection control structures. Now, in this video, I will show you how to use nested if statements and also how to implement a multiple-way selection control structure. So the nested if statement and multiple way selection control structures are very useful when we want our program to choose between multiple action statements so that it will allow the user to decide among multiple options. The multiple way selection control structure can take two distinguishable forms. The first form is the classical one, involving an if statement that has multiple selection paths. So on the screen here, I have written the syntax or the code representing a multiple way selection control structure. As you can see, first I have declared my integer variable score, and I am storing the value 100 in it. And down here, I have my if statements. So I have if, the condition, then the action statement. Down here, I have else, if, another condition, and another action statement. The following statements are also following the same logic. So down the last here that we have is an else statement, and then we have our last action statement. These if statements are executed from top down. So as soon as one of the conditions here in these if statements is evaluated to true, then the action statement associated with that if is executed and the rest of the action statements are going to be skipped. And also if none of the conditions in this statement is evaluated to true, then the final else statement will be executed. So that means, for example, here I have stored the value 100 in my variable score. If I run this, you will see that it's going to be the first action statement that will be executed. If I change this to 80, the second action statement will be the one executing. And if I change to 70, the third action statement will execute. If I say 60 here, then the fourth. And then if I say 50, since none of these conditions is going to be evaluated to true, then the last action statement will be the one executing. So this is how you can implement a multiple way selection control structure. And as you can see, we have if statements, we have multiple conditions. So based on whether or not the condition is evaluated to true, then the action statement is going to be executed. The second form of a multiple way selection control structure is what we commonly call the nested if statement. So a nested if is an if statement that is the target of another if or else statement. So in other words, a nested if statement means that you have got an if statement inside another if statement. So that means that in Java, we have the possibility to nest if statements within other if statements. That is to say that we can place an if statement inside another if statement. So let me show you how a nested if statement looks like. So first of all, I'm going to change my integer variable here, and I will call it int temperature, and I will choose to store the value 50 in it. And down here, I'm going to say if. Next, I will write the condition, temperature is greater than or equal to, let's say 50. And then here, I'm going to write another if statement. Temperature is greater than or equal to 80. And down here, I'm going to do System.out.println. And inside the brackets, I'm going to type good day for swimming. And after, I'm going to do an else statement that will say System.out.println. And in here, I'll say good day for golfing. And here I will just say else output good day for tennis. So this is how a nested if statement looks like. And as you can see here, I have the first if statement and then the condition. And inside that if statement, I have nested another if statement. So this second if statement is going to be executed only when the first condition is going to be evaluated to true. So if it does not evaluate to true, this nested if statement is going to be skipped, and then the else statement will be the one executing. Here I am storing the value 50 in my variable temperature. If I run, you will see what will happen. So what is happening here is that I'm getting good day for golfing. So that means that this second action statement is the one executing. So what has happened here is that, okay, this condition has been met. So since this has evaluated to true, then the second if statement is normally going to be executed. When it reaches the second if statement, it is going to try to evaluate this second condition here. If it evaluates to true, then this first action statement will be the one executing. But if it evaluates to false, then the second if statement, the second action statement will be evaluated. So because the value stored in temperature is 50, the first condition is evaluated to true. But then in the second condition here, it is evaluated to false. So that means that this first action statement will be skipped, and then we will reach the second action statement here. So that's why we are getting good day for golfing, which is corresponding to the second action statement. You will see if I give it the value of 90 here and then run, we'll get good day for swimming, okay? Because this evaluates to true. The second statement also will evaluate to true. That means that this first action statement will be the one executing. But if I give it the value of 40, you will see that the first action statement will evaluate to false. The second action statement will evaluate to false as well. So that means that these action statements are going to be skipped. Then we will reach our else portion of the code. So we will get good day for tennis. So that's what we are having. So guys, that was it concerning the multiple way selection control structures and the nested if statements. So thanks for viewing. I hope this video was informative, and please do not forget to like and subscribe to this channel. Let's meet in the next video.